Uh-huh. All right, one, two, ladies and gentlemen. We are live from the soccer field of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. This is the 175th independence celebration of the Republic of Liberia. A little country in West Africa. In 1847, she declared herself an independent country, and the first political independence country in Africa. And so the 175th celebration is going on right now at the soccer field. Yeah, we are here coming to you from Pennsylvania, Philadelphia. And so I'm going to turn the camera around to carry you around. I'll be talking to the people here. And so as you join, please share the link for us. Please share. I'm going to be carrying the camera around so you can see what's going on here. So I'll be going around. And so to ask the people questions here and see what the make of you want to go? Alright, so I'm going to take you around. It's a different section here, so you can see what's going on here in the soccer field. We got different areas, and so I'm going to carry the camera around. I'll be talking to people here.
Let's go, Coca! Look at the flag and just fuck your right there. Valentino, I need my light. We about to turn up.
Yeah, this is how we do it in Philly. This is Philadelphia. All the politicians, they are here as well. I'll be talking to a lot of people. And so you want to share the link for us. Share the show for us. Let me see what I can invite some people here. Let me invite some of my friends.
Let's go! Lifestyle Coca!
All right, let's get around here and see. Let me show you the first lady, VOSD. The first lady is here. Oh, baby, you will be the first to start going around with the camera here and asking people what they think of the 175th independence celebration of Liberia. So what is your thought?
Well, I mean, it's okay, it's good. I need people coming out here to celebrate the July 26th. You know, but today, like, I call my sister in Liberia. So I was calling, I called my sister and I asked her, what are you guys doing for this?
Talk to you later. That's the first lady. Yeah, but the people are hearing you on Facebook. What's up, boss?
How am I supposed to move?
Is that happy independence or unhappy independence?
Actually, I would like to say happy independence to all Liberians. With all the difficulty and the tough times we go through, I think it's a one day set aside that we all have to celebrate that we all are Liberians. No matter where we are from, our party differences, we should put it aside. There are some people out there in the world who don't have food to eat, but some of us have chicken. Some of us who have food to send over, some of us who didn't have food to send money. But regardless, we are all Liberians. So I think it's a day for all to celebrate and forget about politics. Forget about everything. I heard a lot of people speaking about other divisions. My thing is celebrate. So one day, tomorrow you can't celebrate the 26th. Why celebrate one 26th? You got to talk politics on 26th. So it's about 26th. My goal, I want you guys to celebrate 26th. Please take this to every Liberian. Forget about everything. If you have burger, we eat it and smile. Because tomorrow, you will be gone and there will be no more 26 again. Thank you. Have a blessed day.
What's your name?
This is Lasana, Dr. L, a.k.a. Lazo. Make it talk all.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. That's Lasana right there. We're getting around with the camera. Let's see what we can talk to people here. To think what they think of the July 26th. We are also. So what do you make of the 26th? Are you doing? What's your talk about the 26th? All right, she's shy. Hey, baby, you want to say something about the 26th?
We outside. See, I'm already lit. We outside, okay? Happy July 26th to all my Liberians around the world. We love you.
All right. Oh, you ready to talk now? Okay. All right, how you doing?
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Limu Amara. Limu Amara.
Okay. Oh, is it a happy 26 or a happy 26?
It's a happy 26.
Why is that so?
Because I like a happy 26 for me. Because I'm glad I'm alive today. But for Liberians, I don't think so. It's a happy 26 because we are way backward, and this 26, I pray that peace, unity, and understanding should be between us in America, Europe, Liberia, everything. I pray to God that everything will be okay. This 26 will bring a lot of good opportunities and a blessing and a favor to us. Thank you.
Okay, what's your name?
Limu Amara.
Okay, thank you so much. We're going to be going around here and see what the... Let's talk to some leaders here. We're just going around trying to get people's sentiment, what they make of the it's not yet July 26th, but it's almost July 26th. So Liberia is almost 175 years old. What are we celebrating, sir?
July 26th of Liberia. Peace in Liberia. That's all.
Talk about the economic challenges the people are grappling with. It doesn't bother you?
None at all.
Okay. So what is your name?
I'm from Grandjean, Zuedu.
Let me talk to the Honorable President. How are you doing, sir?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Great. Is that happy 26 or happy 26?
Well, it is a happy 26 because we are alive. So we are happy to see this day. So we are okay. There are so many obstacles we went through. And if we can get to this date, then we are happy. Today is a happy 26.
But there are a lot of children in Liberia that are hungry right now. And we have all the food here. I mean, are we happy because we have it?
Well, I'm not in Liberia. So those that will be celebrating in Liberia should be able to know whether they're hungry or not. But so long I'm in America, I'm not hungry and I'm celebrating it on this side of the world.
So you okay with the economic situation in the country?
Well, in the country, those are there will determine. But for me, I'm in America. Thank you.
Would you consider yourself a patriot?
Very much. I am a patriot.
Well, you don't sound patriotic right now.
No, to be honest, the country is going through so many things that we wish that would be a change after some time. Even though we've been independent for a very long time, but we are not really come up with something that we can say, yeah, we are independent at this time, but the freedom is there and we are happy, we are alive.
So you are a community leader. What impact are you making back home?
Well, I'm the president of the Bison District Association in Liberia, and we are doing some developments. People from Bison will be able to tell you what we are doing. I'm not here to name what I'm doing or what I've done in the county. Thank you very much.
Let me talk to Mr. Yolo. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing fine, sir.
What do you make of the 26?
Thank God that we live to be part of the celebration of our 175th Independence Day celebration. And at least the COVID rule has relaxed for us on the side of the world that we can once more come out and mingle with our friends and enjoy the last 2 months of our summer we have. And then probably a bit after the summer we'll go back into our chef again.
So what message do you have for the leaders back home?
In the most time, we tend to give the leaders message, but I think we should also look at the citizen, what the citizen can do for themselves. In the speech of the late president, John F. Kennedy, doing his inaugural address, and say it's not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. But
the leaders got to provide the opportunity for the people to do something, though.
Yeah, the people do have a decision to make. They vote in bad leaders and they get bad results. So I was just talking with a few of my friends. So the problem with African leaders and their citizens, the citizens don't vote based on their own problem, but they vote based on what they just see in the shortest future. What I mean is that someone comes to you and says, look, I will give you Begore, vote for me. So at the end of the day, you get Begore, your vote is bought. So once your vote is bought, you cannot hold it, man, accountable for your economic hardship because you voted just for Begore. But if you're voting based on what you think is right, then you will encourage other people to do the same.
Well, how do we change the dynamic, though, the way the people vote? What can we do about it?
The same thing we do here. Let the citizens put money into political campaigns instead of political campaigns supporting the voter, telling them, look, I will give you something when you vote for me. In this part of the world, America, our politicians, we contribute to the political campaign. So at the end of the day, when the fall short, we as citizens, as voters, we hold them accountable. They are accountable to us. But the reverse way is what's happening in Liberia and most part of Africa. So all we need to do to curtail corruption is to first look at our laws. What the law say? You get ex-president and corrupt. Our country say you cannot prosecute any ex-president for a crime that was committed while they were president and they have left the office. But yeah, on this side of the world, it's different. So we need to first look at our law. What our law says about prosecuting corruption. So when we start going after corrupt people,
all right, Mr. Yolo, thanks you too. Thank you so much. All right, let me get the camera around here.
You want to say something?
Happy Independence Day.
What is it happy? Why?
You said what?
Yeah.
Wait, what did you say?
Why is it happy 26? What is happy about it?
Because we're a free land.
Are you free?
Yes, I'm free.
In what sense are you free?
I don't know.
What's your name?
Yo, Del Mande.
All right, guys, let's see. It's a July 26th celebration here in Philadelphia. And so we are getting around and see to talk to people. The 26th celebration in Pennsylvania, USA. So let's see who are going to get here to talk to somebody quickly. Hey, ladies, you want to say something? 26? You want to say something? Are you celebrating the 26?
Maybe.
Maybe. What does that mean?
I'm American.
American?
Yeah, I'm just
Liberian. So what did they tell you about the 26?
It's the Independence Day.
Okay, so you are here to celebrate with us?
Yes, I am.
So
I'm Nigerian, so like.
You what?
I'm Nigerian.
You're Nigerian?
Yeah. How old are you guys
today? 175.
That's amazing.
Who did you guys get your independence from?
The American Colonization Society. All right, guys, let's get around here. Let's see. We can get a camera around here and talk to the comrades here. Hey guys, you wanna say something to our July 26th? And they coming?
Yeah, our July 26th is.
What is your name first?
Oh, my name is Kelvin. Kelvin. Yeah, I live up at Derby, 69th Street. Firstly, I should say thank you for putting me on your broadcast. Yeah, and first of all, the 26th, July 26th is really grand to be real with you from yesterday. We've been having a lot of fun over here, and we got a couple of organizations that are trying to, some of our brothers over here, brothers and sisters over here, and they're striving to get some, permit that will permit them to be, like they say, a permanent resident for the United States of America. And We got an organization that trying to help in the process. Yeah, so we got a lot of things going on here, and over there when you look back there, we got a free drinks there. They got free drinks, they got free food, everything is over there. That's the organization heading.
What is the name of the organization?
To be specific, I don't know the name of the organization, to be real with you, because it's my boss lady who lead.
So exactly what are we celebrating? The country is 175 years today. What exactly are we celebrating?
We celebrating Liberia 175 years anniversary, like you previous stated. Yeah, today make Tuesday going to make Liberia 175 years. But we that over in the diaspora, like America, we decided to use the weekend and make the days to be a unique one and try to enjoy ourselves the best way we can, enjoy ourselves. And
in your view, are we independent? Are we independent? Would you say that
Liberia
is Liberia independent?
Liberia, let me just give you my own point of view. For my own view, Liberia is not like totally independent. Liberia is not.
What is
Liberia is lacking a lot of things. Liberia is lacking a lot of things, like in terms of government issues and stuff like that, because President, my man, I know a lot of things about Liberia. Yeah, you know, Liberia is lacking a lot of things, especially for the kind of government we got right now that running the country. You know, our people is suffering in Liberia.
You sound like opposition.
No, I'm not an opposition. I'm not nobody. I'm just a neutral.
Objective man.
Yeah, I'm just
a... All right, come on. Nice talking to you, man. All right, let's see. You want to say something, man? Are you good? Okay, all right. The July 26th celebration. Should I say pre-July 26th? Guys, you want to say something about the 26th?
We're just enjoying the day, that's all.
What is enjoyable about the day?
Everybody out. Enjoying yourself, eating, having fun, talking to new people.
Liberia will be 175 years in a few days. Are we independent?
No.
What is lack?
We're not together yet. When we're together, we'll be independent.
What do you mean? Explain a little bit.
We're independent, but the Liberian people are not together.
In America or back?
Both Liberia and back home.
We are here, man. We just can't get here. We are not together. This is not sound of unity.
We just had two Baron IE and we had two different cookout for Liberian people. That's not right.
Okay. So what is your name again?
Call me Coach AB.
All right, thank you, buddy. Hey, sir, you want to say something? All right. Hey, boss, we're just carrying the camera around here. And then talk about the coming 26th.
Happy July 26th to Mother Liberia. And I pray that Liberia's citizens or Liberian people get unified. Unification. and pray God for longevity for Liberia.
So when you say happy July 26th, the last time I checked in the country, poverty is all over the place. I mean, are we happy because we have it in America, or we are happy for the people back home?
I'll hold it for you.
I'm happy because we free, but not happy because we're not united. So if we're not united, we ain't come with no idea to help these people back home, or to come with a unique idea to make it stable.
This is not a sign of unity?
Yeah, together.
We just, back home, we're not together. Because we got tribes that had to unify. We got peoples and stuff that had to unify. That's why we're not together. But happy July 26th.
All right, buddy. Thanks. All right, boss. And I come here by the 26th. What?
Hey, boss.
I like that sika, man. I wish I could have some. What I can pop a hole? Let me talk to the boss. Is that happy 26th or unhappy 26th?
It's happy 26th, though.
Why is that so?
You can never go wrong with our independence. It's our independence. That's why money or no money, we still have to celebrate our independence.
What is your name?
I'm Eka Nere.
Nere? I mean, a lot of our people are suffering by home. So what are we celebrating?
Listen, people have been suffering a long time before 1847. So we just have to live for it. We have to celebrate our independence. America have people suffering. People be hungry, living all down the street, sleep outside. They still celebrate their independence. So we have to celebrate our independence.
Majority of the people are doing good here.
Listen, majority of the people suffering here too. Go down Philadelphia, go and brush. You see people sleeping in the street. Celebrate your independence and live better. Thank you.
Thank you, bud. Thank you. Hey, Richmond. Liberia will be 175 in few days. Are we independent?
Nah, you hijack your independent.
We hijack it?
Yeah, nobody colonized you, so you're going to get independent.
So what, I mean, they said Liberia was under the yoke of the American Colonization Society, though.
Yeah, free slave when you founded Liberia, like what we know about. But aiming the independent, nobody getting colonized. Nobody colonizing them.
So we are not independent, in other words?
We say we independent. We didn't want our own. But
what do you say?
I'm Liberian, so we say. The Constitution say.
Are you going with the flow?
I wasn't there when they wrote the Constitution. I made it there, so I read it. And that's what we're going by.
All right, man. Thank you, Richmond. You want to say something? Oh, sure. More definitely. What is your name?
Aromia Puku Brisbane.
Are we independent?
Yes, we are.
We don't manufacture anything in the country. We don't even rice. We can't produce rice to feed ourselves. In what sense are we independent?
Yeah, we're independent by political right of the universal suffrage. That is, We came into different stages. We came from the colonial period, the Commonwealth period, then we came into the Republican period. So you got to take into consideration all those facts and find that Liberia as a sovereign nation. Then we consider that we are an independent nation, despite our economic, social disparity, despite our people in abject poverty, the nation is poverty-stricken, and our people poverty-driven, we still retain and maintain that we are an independent country.
So again, I'll ask a question. We can't produce a tire, nothing. We can't produce, clean water. Our own citizens, their medical facilities are lacking in the country. I mean, a whole host of things as an independent country, things that we're supposed to do, we are not doing it, but we say we are independent. Is that pseudo-independence?
Right. It might be pseudo-independent as you term it, but that cannot take our independence away. Despite the fact that we do not have the factor of production, in that we're not self-sufficient in all these different facets that you're talking about. But
I thought when you are independent, you are self-sufficient, isn't it?
No. We have several independence. Independence in our social, economic, political setting, and independence in as a sovereign nation. So when you talk about Liberia being a sovereign nation, we are independent. Despite our
politically, we are independent.
Yeah, despite our production capacity is very low, you know, and our people in that kind of a social economic or degradation, but we are still independent and we're proud to tell the world. that we are an independent nation and we can do better and we can do the best for tomorrow.
So, when do you think we're going to achieve independence, or economic independence?
Well, we need a government that is very formidable. A government that will tackle the social, political facets of society. We need a government that will determine that, hey, look, the slope, we are at a down slope. Our people is poverty-driven, the nation is poverty-stricken. So when we have a genuine independent government that is concerned about the well-being and social economic factor of our country, we will grow from that economic status to a better...
In other words, the current government is not doing that?
No. The current government is not doing that because if we look at the current government grade, in terms of proficiency and efficiency and economic growth, we can determine that the current government has a down slope with poverty. So economically, we are backward.
The government is pro-poor. The guys are not seeking the interests of the poor?
The precepts and the concept of pro-poor is a brand name that the government has brought in as a nomenclature to characterize our people, be very good, not that the people is in economic degradation.
Joey has been in power for nearly 6 years. One thing would you point out that he is doing right?
I can't say anything George Wright is doing right now because I'm not so much of being adequately informed on his developmental issue. But likewise, one of the most important things I would like for George Wright to do for the people is to lift the people from the economic suffering.
You say you are not adequately informed though, but at the same time you're saying the government is not doing well. So what are you getting the information from?
I'm getting information from so many sources in our economic setting with the World Bank and other kind of stuff like that. But we are saying that our people actually our nation is poverty striking and our people poverty driven.
Okay. What is your name again?
I'm Romeo Puku Brisbane.
Okay, Romeo, thank you so much. All right. Hey, I love your cray. You want to say something for me? Excuse me? That is 26 cray. All right, guys, this is Voice of Sino here. We are just carrying the camera around and see great people here. Hey, ladies, you want to say one or two words to the Voice of Sino with Esoteric? July 26th, is that happy or unhappy?
Happy July 26th.
Why is that so? Why is it happy?
Because it's our independent day.
Are we independent?
Yes.
By virtue of what?
I don't know that one.
All right, you want to say something?
No.
What's up, boss? Is that a happy 26 or unhappy 26?
It is a happy 26.
Okay, elaborate.
Oh, it is a happy 26, one, because Liberia is an independent nation that makes decisions on their own. We could not be independent, probably in terms of creating job opportunity, producing food for ourselves, but I want to believe in as much as we can have a free and fair election and we have a leadership that determine where we head and what do we do for ourselves. Definitely, it's an independent nation. Though we are not sufficient, self-sufficient, but it's an independent nation.
Okay, so politically, we are independent. But economically, we are not.
Economically, we are still behind and we need progress.
Say that again.
Economically, we are behind. We need progress.
Okay, we need progress. Economically, what facet are we doing well?
Economically, I think basically from 1847 to present, not much has been done, really. It will take the courage of a leader to change the dynamic of the situation in Liberia. So when it comes to economic empowerment, we are yet to move forward. But gradually, we're getting there.
Gradually, we'll get it. Thank you, buddy. Thank you. All right, guys, so we are getting around here. Hey, lady, you want to say something? 26? 27? Happy or unhappy?
27. I'm happy.
You're happy?
Yes.
Tell me why you're happy.
Well, because we're celebrating our Independence Day and, you know, I'm still alive.
We can't produce rest in the country. Are we independent?
No, we're not really.
When we say we're independent, tell me, how are we independent?
For us, yeah, we're independent. For the poor back on the night.
Oh, okay, so the independence for those who are back in America here. So the people by when they are dependent.
No, they're dependent, but most of them are the people who enjoy the government money. They don't want independent right now. Okay. But a lot of help needs to be done for people back home.
What's your name?
My name is Catherine.
All right, Catherine, thank you so much. Thank you. All right, guys, this is it. The VOSD here. We are on the Soccer Field. It's a celebration of the July 26th. Let me see. It's jam-packed here. Everywhere. The people are all over the place. Let me see what I can talk to the beautiful lady here. Is that happy July 26th or unhappy July 26th? What would you say?
It's a happy July 26th.
Explain why.
Because we're celebrating our country.
Is that economic celebration or poverty celebration?
Hey, listen, it's a celebration.
What is your name?
Amelia.
Amelia, thank you so much. All right, guys, here we go here. We got some beautiful ladies here, LRP. We got a beautiful lady. You see, she's showing her finger to me, so I'm bringing the camera to her. Oh,
are you again?
That you? Yeah. She's dangling at me.
Simeon and Grill.
Pardon me?
Simeon Restaurant and Grill.
Oh. You want to say something to us? Explain about how that. Tell us.
Stay.
Okay.
To motherfucking Liberia. Period.
Why are you insulting our country?
Please delete that.
All right, guys. All right.
Let's do a video on me.
Huh?
Let's do a video on me saying happy independence.
Let's okay.
Happy Independence Day to Mama Liberia. Period.
So I can't allow you to go with that though. What are we happy about?
The mark out last night. For another year. You added to our freedom.
Our freedom. Who is suppressing us?
I don't know.
Okay.
No,
okay.
No,
all right. Hey guys, you want to? Hey boss man, you want to say something about the 26th?
Look at your cigar, but me enjoy you.
You're in the mood to talk right now. Okay, I'll call you a slack. Yeah, the best name, woman, you want to say so happy to the city or unhappy to the city?
I want to say happy to the city to all Liberians, all over the world.
Are you saying happy to the city to the children by whom that are hungry too? Some of them, they don't have it to eat right now.
Yes, I am saying happy to the city to everybody. Even though they don't have to eat, but they are still alive. That's the greatest thing in life right now. You have to be alive.
How can somebody be happy? No food in their stomach.
Because they are Liberian, want to. I know our government, officials, and our president will do something for our people.
Okay, cross talking.
I said it all.
I didn't hear you. She was in that room a little bit. Repeat that, please.
You said what?
Okay, let me ask a question. Are we dependent or independent?
Huh?
We are independent. But we can't produce cassava, rice, chicken, and nothing. We're begging people 24/7 to help.
Come on, we can produce, but we are just lazy set of people. That's all.
Liberians are lazy?
Yes, right now.
I was in Liberia 2020, I was there. The children are in the street selling. Is that laziness?
No, we are not talking about the people in Monrovia. We are talking about the people
in the interior
right now. Because when I say they are lazy, they now depend on the people from Monrovia to give them chicken, pepper, bitter boy, and other things. But before then, I know that when we used to leave from Monrovia to the rural areas, we used to get bitter boy, okra, and other things in the...
That's a strong one when you say they are lazy. How are they surviving though? Why are they not dead?
They're not everybody planting right now. They're not everybody going back to the soil. Some are just there depending on hand to mouth. From hand to mouth, that's why I'm saying they are lazy.
So in order for them not to be lazy, what do you expect them to do?
For us to go back to the soil. To depend on ourselves, but not other people. Some of us will get our people out there when we send them $100, $200, they eat it right away, and they still want some, no.
Okay.
They have to do something for themselves. They are saying $100, you eat $25, do business for the $75, then I know you are growing. Thank you.
Well, you gotta learn how to do business, you know, to be a business person.
I know, right now I'm sorry, I already said what I have to say. Thank you, happy to listen to everybody.
All right, thank you, what's your name?
My name is Christine Beautiful M. King.
All right, guys. This is the July 26th celebration here, or pre-July 26th. Normally when it gets a weekday, then the people are celebrating. So you can see, as you can see here, the place is parked with people. I'll carry you around and talk to get more voices here. More voices, this is the voice of Sano, and we are going around and talk to more people. Hey, happy 26th. Imagine you get nothing to say. you are watching Voice of Sino with Esoteric. Hey, boss man, how you doing? July 26th. You want to say one or two words, 26?
Yeah. Happy 26th to everybody.
What is your name?
My name is Mark.
So I heard what happened. What are we happy for?
Happy to be alive. Yeah, we happy to be alive. That's it.
Hey, the CEO of Sylvia. Is that happy 26 or unhappy 26?
Happy 26 to us.
Explain to us.
Very happy to be alive to celebrate our Independence Day. We here to have fun with our friends and family.
Hey boss, one or two words about the 26?
Happy 26 and live life and have fun.
What's your name?
Ahmed.
All right, thanks. All right, guys, we are here. Okay, all right. I see. Yes. So, shout out now, 26.
What do you want me to say right now? Happy July 26 to all in Liberia around the world. We love you guys. We have to celebrate this day today. Happy to see my brother promoting us. How do you call it?
Esoteric.
Esoteric VIP. One love for you, baby.
Thank you. That's my. Hey, boss. What's up, man? What's going on? How you? You looking good, man.
Yeah, thank you.
One or two words about the 26.
We just drove out here to hang out with our people. You know, July 26. You never go wrong with that. So it's fun. Happy Independence Day, Liberia, and we're just having a great time.
All right, man. Thank you. We are here, man. 26, Voice of Sino. We are going around. And this is Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, United States of America. That's where we are. All right. You are welcome. If you can catch a flight now, if you're not here, Africa, anywhere, just come. All right. Gentlemen, how you doing? Happy 26 or unhappy 26?
Happy 26.
Explain.
No.
I say happy.
It's a lot of shit going on tonight. I mean, you need to be here to know. That's what I need to tell you. It's a lot of stuff going on. And we are happy on Philly. We are chilling and coming down in Philly tonight. Thank you, guys.
Say something? All right, guys. So we are here. It's a VOSD. All right, see, I'll show you the phone here. There's a lot going on here. Yeah, this is how we do it in the United States, celebrating our country. Yes. Samo, you want to say one or two words about 26, man?
Happy 26 to all Liberians all around the world.
Okay, what are we happy about?
I mean, it's our Independence Day, so like we gotta, and we'll be very happy about it, you know. So everybody rejoice, and see the whole field, the whole place is packed with so Liberians.
Are we independent or dependent?
Independent Day.
I mean, our leaders are going all around the world and begging people for help. Are we independent?
Well, I can say, yes, we are independent. Still, we'll step back, but we're independent, we're free.
In what sense are we independent?
And since 1847, man.
What's up, boss? You want to say one or two words to us?
Why not? Okay. Yeah.
What's your name?
Harry Chiroplay.
Okay. Liberia will be 175 in a few days. Are we independent?
I guess there are levels of independence, but not quite, not totally independent yet. We are still economically depending on a lot of people, a lot of things, you know. Most of the social, economic programs in Liberia are still being dictated by outsiders. So, no, we are not totally independent yet, but we are working towards it.
So what is lacking in order for us to be economically independent?
Man, if I knew that answer, man, I wouldn't be here.
All right, thank you. So,
Harry Trouble.
All right, thank you so much. Okay, guys, there you go. There, interesting input over there. Let me see. Well, maybe I can talk to one of the ladies here. Let me talk to a look at the celebrities are here. Hey, ladies, you want to say one or two words about the 26? It's a voice of Sino in the diaspora. Who's the spokesperson? How you doing? Is that happy 26 or unhappy 26?
Happy 26.
Explain why it's happy.
Because my country's independence, so it's happy 26.
We get rice from other country. Our staple food, we don't produce anything. Are we independent or dependent?
Well, I'll still say we are independent. Once we were colonized by the American colonization society and they put us on our own, I'll say we are independent.
Okay. Also, we struggle for it, though. They didn't put us on our own.
Well, we struggle for it, so we are independent.
All right. What's your name again?
Dorothy.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. All right, your spoke person did good. All right. What she say? All right, guys, so we are here on the soccer field. Hey, guys, you want to say one or two words about the 26? And a comment? 26? Who's the spokesperson, man? Somebody got to say something, man.
Happy Independence Day.
All right. Oh, what's your name?
My name...
Mr. Swin.
All right, man, guys. All right, we're just getting around here and try to talk to the ladies different. Hey, lady, how you doing? Happy 26. Want to say one or two words about 26?
This is my first time here.
Pardon me?
This is my first time here.
Okay.
And I'm enjoying myself. I love it, and I know I'll come back.
What's your name?
Shadana.
Shadana. Are you an American or Liberian?
American.
American. You are here to celebrate with us.
Yes.
What is your experience so far?
What is my experience so far?
Yeah.
Love.
Okay, you love?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you for celebrating with us.
Have all a right. good one. Thank
all
you.
Right. All right. Okay, guys. There you have it. Hey, Chi. We are just carrying the camera around to ask people what you think about the 26. Any thought?
Happy 26 to all Liberians, man, around the world.
They are all Liberians back home, man. They are hungry right now. Should we say happy to them when somebody is hungry?
Oh, well, a little bit difficult, but you know what? Okay. They'll be all right.
By virtue of what, they will be okay, but
we try our best. At least, because for us, we're still looking out for family member, friends, and everybody else, you know, most especially the 26. So, don't be all right, man. You know, one way or the other, because one person will help another person. That's a good thing. You know, because not a lot of people that got family or friends abroad. So, yeah, but don't be all right, man, you know.
Okay, all right.
You want to say how you doing, man? No, he said it all.
Okay, he said it all. Okay, all right. He's a spokesman.
My friend.
Oh, okay, all right.
Yeah, bro. Thank you, my man.
No problem. Happy 26.
Hi.
What you got to say to us? We the Liberians are celebrating today. Is that happy 26 or unhappy 26?
Happy 26 to everybody. We are all grateful for our country, Mama Liberia. I am proud to be a Liberian. We'll always be proud to be a Liberian. Thank you, everybody.
There are a lot of people right now, when you go by, when the children are hungry. The mother right now, they're thinking how to feed their children. Should we also say happy to them when they are hungry?
No, we can say happy to them, but I know the Lord will provide for them. Yeah, the Lord will provide. They won't seem hungry. So.
What's your name?
Love.
Love, thank you. Let it in red now? No? Okay. Okay. I got the presidential candidate on camera again. How you doing? How you doing, boss?
Good. Oh, I'm good. Thank you for coming. We really appreciate you. This is Wilbert Newell Foley, a candidate for the presidency of the Liberia Association of Pennsylvania.
What message do you have for us, man? A big day coming up, 175th. Political independence coming up. And
the only thing I can tell Liberia in the state of Pennsylvania, this is the perfect opportunity for them to transform their community. And the best way you can transform your community is electing a new breed of people. People with vision. People who are ready to work. People who have more to prove to the community. People who have the know-how to transform the community. And that is the Wilbert Newell Foley and Emma guy with him. Foley guy with him, a new breed of people, new breed of leaders who are ready to work. Look, more than 44 years the association has been around. We don't have an office, we don't have a community center, we don't even have a hall. And what we are saying to you is, give us the opportunity and we'll give you those things. The first thing we'll give you is a community center. In that community center, we will have one or two halls Liberia can use at a discount rate. We'll have after-school programs where we will volunteer our time. We will also seek funding to ensure that our programs run all year round, and so that we can have the best brains to help us keep the program going. So I will tell you, as a classroom teacher, I'm a graduate of Temple University and a Duke University fellow. I was brought to this country by Duke University, based on the fact that my own experience, I graduated from high school, college, through the assistance of people who I did not know, I want to provide our same services to our young people. Our campaign, our objective, our platform is focused on capacity building. We are going to work with the young people. We are going to work with Liberians of all ages. We are going to provide Liberians with defense lawyers to ensure that they don't take plea deals, because plea deal entraps people. It prevents you from even getting full stamp, financial aid, and other government programs that are useful for the family, that are very helpful for the family. So we'll provide a defense lawyer to the library. We'll provide immigration services as well as immigration lawyers in times of hearing. We're also going to have other literacy programs. We are going to have computer training programs. And to improve the mental health of our senior citizens, we are going to have at least one or two days for our senior citizens where they can come out, especially during winter, they can come out and hang out with fellow senior citizens. They can play bingo, they can play ludo, they can play whatever they can do, just the idea of getting out of the house. And that in itself is another way to help our senior citizens cope with the cold weather, and just instead of just being stuck in the house. But our primary goal as a classroom teacher, and I'm seeing what No Child Left Behind is doing to a lot of the inner city students. That is why we came in this race, because we want to help. We want to tutor our kids. We want to prepare them for college. Currently, a lot of the kids that graduated from high school may not make it to college because of No Child Left Behind. They all expect to go to the next class the next year. So as a result, there's no competition, there's no challenge. Whether they do the work or not, they will move to the next class. So we have to prepare our kids. Liberian children of Liberian descent, we want to prepare them for the next line, want to put up to college. So come vote for the 40 guy with them.
When is the election again?
The election is August 19th. And in order to vote, you have to register. The Liberian Association of Pennsylvania is a member-driven organization. Just being Liberian, living in Pennsylvania, does not qualify you to vote. You have to register to vote. And the registration is $35 per person. So we are asking you to contact us. There are people who believe in.
What is your contact information?
You can call me you can call me president. My campaign manager is has been reassigned to another state. We have several numbers we can provide to you. You can call me 610-804-0986. 610 804-0986. That is my personal number. Call me. Anything relating to the Liberian community, call me. I'm willing to help. And there are people who believe in us, who are raising funds to help those who cannot afford, and those who also don't feel the need to pay because they don't see what the association is doing. Well, the association have been doing something. We just want to come and we just want to pick up from where they stop, and we want to transform the association to attract more members.
All right. Wilma, thank you so much, man. The music is a little loud, so I can ask a lot of questions. All right, thank you. Thank you. That's the. All right. All right, guys. So this is the we just. Hey, ladies, you wanna say something? July 26th, and a comment.
Sure. Good evening, everyone. My name is Elma Garway. I'm running for VP for LAP. Okay, that's so you know we're here to celebrate, and we're saying vote for Fuller Gawa team.
Why should I vote for you?
Oh, because there's so many things we need to do. This establishment has been here since 1978, and we have nothing to show as a community. With us, we're trying to have a community center. Not one, but two halls that people can rent out, celebrate, have functions like this. We're going to have after-school programs for children. Being a mother, I know how much it is. It's expensive. My mom had to work two jobs to give me the life that I have that I'm here today. So if I can help a single mom or a parent provide services for her child while she goes to work. Senior Citizen Day, if you got an older mother that can come out, play ludo, you understand. We're going to provide lawyers for people. So many people take plea deals just to avoid the system of going to jail, but they don't know what they're doing. So people that will advise you, help with your papers, you understand? When you take a plea, you can't get financial aid in this country. You can't get food stamps. You can't get any benefits.
So, madam, you talk about getting hall and all those things. Sure. But it's cash intensive. How do you hope to get the money?
I tend to get this money. The American people, they love Africans. Liberia is very close to America. There's fundings allocated for things like this. They have money, but you have to be smart, write proposal to get grants and things like that. So if you do your part, they will give you money. That's
Have you done the feasibility study for the hall?
Oh, absolutely.
How much are we talking about?
Depending if you're building from scratch, you understand, or depending if you're getting a building. Like they had a community, we had a building, like we had a building that they gave for $100, but nobody could fix that hall. So if we're building from scratch, which is what we intend to do, it could cost well over $1 million.
What do you intend to do?
With what? What do you mean? I already told you. So have these things set up for my community.
Like the building, are you building from scratch or are you going to rent
somewhere? We'll see how that goes. We'll see how that goes. It's better to build from scratch so that it can be tailored for our needs. So for now, we're leaning more towards that.
Do you have opposition right now?
Of course. Why?
So why are you better than your opposition?
I don't speak about that.
Why?
Why? Because I know what I bring to the table.
So
my form is to talk about what I can do for you. Okay. The opposition have to tell me what it can do for you. Okay. May the best team win. They might have very good things that will do. I don't know. I don't.
So you are the best thing.
I will say, for me, I know what I bring to the table. Absolutely, okay. I'm the winning team. Yes.
All right. Thank you so much.
I do wish them well. You understand? Because I feel like if you get in a race like this, you should be passionate. So, you know, bring your game on.
Do you plan to bring them on board when you win? Just in case they don't win, are you planning to bring them on?
Yes.
What is strategy?
Well, this is the thing. We're all one. The whole point of this is to unify Liberians in Pennsylvania. So in the event that they don't win, it doesn't stop here. I have to bring one of the people on board so that we can still continue to get that outpouring of support. Because if their people see, oh, this person's still here, we'll still get more and we'll be giants and do more. So absolutely.
Do you have a background in running non-for-profit organization?
Oh, I do. I have two non-profit organizations myself. Very much. Chocks and Children Helping Other Children in Need. Wow. I started in college. Women helping other women. Absolutely.
Thank you so much. My name is Doc Sayapode Esoteric, the host of Voice of Sino in the Diaspora.
Okay, very nice.
How can we find you? Let me get
your president.
I talked to you the other day.
Is that recorded?
Yeah, it's live right now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'll put it on YouTube and Facebook.
Sure.
867.
Yes, 648.
648.
8149.
8149.
Yeah.
All right, because we need to do in-studio interview, and I need somebody to interview.
Yeah, more definitely. I will call you. Call me now.
Okay.
Yeah, ring something.
Madison Freeman.
Yeah, Madison Freeman on Facebook. It's Doc Cyphor the Esoteric. You all find right. me, and we can talk to her better.
All right.
Yeah, this one is impromptu.
All right.
Yeah. All right, boss. All right, so guys, there you go. There we're talking. It's July 26th celebration. Everybody here, young people, chit-chatting. Beautiful, beautiful people. See them. Hey, what's up, Timmy? Is that 26? Happy 26 or unhappy 26?
Well, we can say happy 26 because we're on the other side of the arc.
Because we are enjoying, so it's happy. How about the people on the other side that are not enjoying?
Well, we leave it out with them yet. Because for us, we're happy because where we came from, this is a time that we always refresh ourselves and then we think about our country and think about where we come from. And the kind of people we are, we usually, with this kind of bond is always where Liberians are. When it's July 26th, I don't care, no matter what the situation may be, whether you're happy or not, you come together, you feel at home because you're away from home. So it's a good thing to always do when you're...
What did you say, like, think about the other people back home and some of the people right there, they are hungry, my man. So a mother right there, no food to feed your child back home. Should we be happy about that too?
Well, it's a politics. I don't want to delve into politics right now.
But there is economics, man. Is that politics?
No. It's a problem that can be handled. And the country, right now, you talk to some people, they're on the side of that story is different. They have everything they want, and life is okay with them. And mind you, on the 26th day, there are people in Liberia who are going to celebrate this day. There are other people who say, oh, yeah, we're hungry. We can't celebrate. But there are two sides of the coin. But we as Liberians, we should always give thanks to God when such time comes. Whether we're happy or whether there's food or there's no food, as long as there's life, there's hope.
When you're hungry, why should you celebrate?
There's a need to celebrate whether you're hungry or not.
Prince, are we independent or not?
We are.
We are by virtue of what?
We are independent by virtue of fact that we are all Liberian, and we need to come together to make this country, Liberia, a great country. I won't be on camera too much.
All right, man. Thank you. All right, team. Thank you, guys. Let me go to the lady over there. All right, guys. So let me, a little interaction with the people here, VOSC, who try to get the voices of the people here and see what they think. See the boss, man, doing your thing. Liberia will be 175 years few days from now. Are we independent or dependent?
Well, it depends. You know, we're from Sierra Leone. We just love our people. Okay. Right. We're just here to celebrate. Whatever it is, we're going to pray for the better.
I believe in Liberia. Right. You know what I mean?
We believe in Liberia.
Again.
Okay.
Y'all independence is independence. It's not dependence, yeah?
All right.
Thank you, man.
Free.
All right.
Thanks for joining us, man. Appreciate you guys. Yeah, it's popping here. Let me get to my lady here. I'll bend away from her for a little bit. You see, this is my family, Esoteric family, yeah? I'm hungry. Yo, looking for me? I know, right? Yeah. I'm about to finish.
You want to hold it?
Yeah. And I want to ask something.
All right, you the camera. I'll show it to you. Ask about it.
Go where?
Anybody you want to ask.
Okay, and you will tell me what to say, right?
You ask.
Huh?
Ask. What is independence?
Okay. What is independence?
What is what?
Independence.
Independence? Oh, you mean for Liberia? It's our country's birthday. Yeah.
What was she asking? Okay, so but what is your understanding of that though?
Well, it's the country's, for example, for independence will be the country's birthday. So like when they got the independence for whoever it is that brought everybody together and celebrate like from that first birthday up until how long that freedom goes, you know? So it's more freedom and many things. Togetherness, happy, show.
All right, it's a lot. Yeah, so, yeah, all right, guys. Go to Miami, they won't get.
Okay, but wait, daddy, I want to ask someone else.
All right, you gotta be a follower.
Okay. I don't want to eat right now.
Okay.
So.
No noise.
Okay. Should we go here?
Yeah, go wherever you want to go. Okay. You got a microphone in your hand. I'll show it to you.
Okay.
All right, guys. Trash up your journalist.
Okay, after independence, what is that? What did I say?
Huh?
After independence, I'm giving you the mic, okay?
What happened?
After I say independence, I'm giving you the mic, okay?
Okay.
Over here.
Yeah, just go ahead.
Hello. What is independence?
Independence is freedom and liberty to do what your culture allows you to do.
Oh, thank you. Thank
you're
you.
So pretty.
Thank you.
Are we independent?
Are we independent? Ooh, Liberia as a country or black people in America?
Liberia as a country.
We're independent. However, we don't have the right guidance, but we're independent, I'd say.
By virtue of what are we independent?
Compared to America, it's less, it's more on you, less on the government. How you succeed, how you know, if you go out there and work.
You mean in Liberia or in the United States?
One more time.
In Liberia or in the United States?
Both, but more so in Liberia, I'd say.
So in Liberia, the people are independent. Would you say that?
They're independent, but they have to work harder. Yes, I'd say that.
Okay, as a country though, my understanding of an independent country is the country that feeds herself, that should be able to provide the economic environment for the people to thrive, right? So, but say for example, in your country, our staple food is rice. We don't even produce rice. Are we independent or dependent?
Ooh, so then you know the answer to your question. Then we're in that aspect, we're dependent.
So in what aspect are we independent?
We have some stuff that people want too, but we just don't know how to utilize the things that we have in order to gain from it. That's what
I'm not asking for what we have. I'm saying are we...
Let it go right now or...
Why not?
Because I'm here to party. You're here to talk politics. I'm not a governor. I'm not a governess. Okay. I'm telling you.
What's your name?
My name is Dee. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Come on, Daddy. Let's go ask Zoe.
Huh?
Let's ask Zoe.
Ask what?
Ask Zoe.
Who's Zoe?
Zoe is my mommy's friend's daughter.
Where is she?
Right
there. So let's call it off. It's a lot of... You got something? All right, so ladies and gentlemen, we'll talk to you later. This is Voice of Sino here. Let's cater to the little ones. Keep following us so you get more videos.